The sun shall never set on so glorious a human achievement. Let freedom reign. God bless Africa. I thank you.
So here's Nelson Mandela in his tiny little cell for decades, and he finds freedom. And then he gets let out, and all he's got for the people who put him in there and his family and his country is further love and freedom to share and to grow and to give. We've just celebrated his 100th birthday, and I think to honor that, we need to share and celebrate freedom. Whether you're an employee or self-employed or unemployed, I think freedom is where you go about your daily work and you explore how to push the envelope, how to take this to the next level, how to improve, how to deliver a better service and enjoy the process, love the process, be proud of the process. It is your attitude of how you engage with the market to improve it, to uplift it, and hopefully to uplift those around you. Freedom is a major component of how we can improve our environment, our workplace, and our own personal inner self. So what I've seen, like established businesses, you know, entrepreneurial businesses or fairly well established commercial businesses in the foreign trade, what they've done is that, and this is time and time again, is using the wrong product in the wrong application and rushing the installation process, where other trades or other mindsets, people with potentially vast experience in other trades, they rush the process or they think they know better than the flooring specialist or the installer, where site conditions are not yet correct, but there's a time limit and penalties will be applied. So things just get snowballed right up into the end. And generally flooring is one of the last elements to go in, and pretty much always a coconut. That's the pressure point of where mistakes happen and floors get ruined or they don't deliver to what they are sold as. With regards to quality, what is quality? Is quality an expectation of a certain caliber of machining and refinement or longevity in a product? Or is quality a spec? Is it a where a product is being built to deliver to a certain price point or experience? This is something that we really need to explore carefully within our flooring industry, because you have so many products coming in from various parts of the world. We have an industry that is driven by price. It's no longer are we putting in floors to a specification, but we're putting in floors to a price point for affordability to make it more attractive. But what are we losing in the process? And this is something that we seriously need to explore going forward. And what is that expectation in quality, in that end experience? It's quite a big subject. We need to explore that quite a bit more. So what I care most about in the flooring industry is skills development and improving the overall game and installation and expertise of the flooring industry in South Africa and sub-Saharan Africa. I believe that our industry is still quite new. We depend a lot on first world countries like Europe and North America, Canada, with regards to instructions and how to do things. But I find that the skill set here, or our environmental conditions here, are also very different. We don't have that skills development program. We don't have skilled artisans that have been in the game for 100 years. So we're moving out of the information age of where, you know, anybody can type into Google a question and get 1,000 different responses. And, you know, people who are selling or selling a concept or an idea, they need to be careful because they can get caught out very quickly. You know, everybody's got a cell phone, everybody can Google. And, you know, we're moving out of this age of information because information is so accessible, through to the age of trust. You just look at this whole Facebook debacle of, do we trust Facebook with our personal information? Do we trust the company or the brand or the installer who is providing a service or a product? And that is going to be a core component of how we grow our industry in the upcoming years and decade, of where you're going to be judged and based on your trust factor, your trust percentage. That's the future, that's tomorrow. So this responsibility lies with all of us, in that even from aspiring from unskilled labor through to the various installers or facilitators of product, on how we install the product to the best of our capabilities and integrity to give longevity, to create a good reputation, that we deliver service through to corporates as well. Corporates must introduce product and sell product of the right caliber and quality without stepping on or taking advantage of an immature market or an immature skill base. And I've seen it all too often where this is the case. And through lack of knowledge, people, industry, and consumers have been taken advantage of. And we need to change this mindset. There is mind-blowing opportunity in foreign education if we can unlock that mass informal workforce that potentially hasn't had the best of opportunities in secondary or tertiary education, but beautiful, clever minds who are just waiting for the opportunity to absorb knowledge which can uplift them, that can give them some pride and something to really sink your teeth into. And if I think of the flooring industry, which I love, you can think of how, you know, you pull somebody off the side of the road and you get them to work with you as a handlanger, and over a period of time they go and they want to take on the next step, and they want to be laying the planks, they want to be doing the street work, and they're stealing with their eyes through practical, almost like apprenticeship experience. Well, if we can get this out to the mass through videos and apprenticeships within the industry, I think we could uplift the skill set as a whole, which just has beautiful knock-on benefits for the industry and the end consumer all the way through. You get a better installation, longevity, you can charge more, you can pay more. Hey, you have fun, you skills upliftment. It's a no-brainer. To do anything but this is dumb. Freedom, I won't let you down. I won't give you up. I'm gonna give you what you need.